Sorting using the standard library is possible. So assume you want to sort an array of or a structure using a specific sorting order. So in our standard library we have this qsort function for sorting. A key question that arises here is how can we sort different data types? It would be possible by providing a sort function for integer, a sort function for float, a sort function for whatever. But that would be very tedious. So the good thing now is that we learned about function pointers, and now it's time to actually put this knowledge to good use. It allows us to specify a comparison function that we can input to the sorting, and therefore we would just need one qsort function and we can sort anything we like. Isn't that amazing? Let's have a look how the signature of qsort looks like in our library. So quicksort or qsort takes an array as input of any type, so its array is a pointer so to void, so it can be anything, like a pointer to a structure, array, or whatever you have, but it must be an array. And this array has num elements, and now qsort has to know the size of each element, for example 4 bytes, 8 bytes, 16 bytes, what have you, and last you give it a comparator. This is now a function pointer, which is defined as follows here. The comparator takes two inputs, void star, what does this mean? Well, it means two elements of our array, basically, we want to compare, and then the comparator returns a negative value. If the first one is smaller than the second one, it returns a larger value than zero. If the second one is bigger than the first one, void returns zero if both are identical. So now you can pass this function anything to sort whatever you like, and using any sorting order. So let's have a look in an example by having our structure student T, which has age and name. Let's create two comparator functions. So we have an age comparator. So it takes two elements, as we said, of this array that are void pointers. And we know, in fact, when we're sorting our student T structure, well, it's not just a void pointer, it's a student T object. So we can cast those objects, those pointers, to be of type student T. That's what we are doing in these brackets. And then if it's we want to compare the age, well, we take the age element. So we take the element age of the first element and subtract the age of the second element. And that is basically the result of our age comparator. And you can check and figure out that it in fact returns a negative number if, you know, one of them is bigger than the other, and so on. Also, we can do a name comparator. So if you want to sort by the name, like starting from A up to Z, and there is a function to support us here. It's called strcmp, or string comparison, which we give as an input the two strings, and then it will return which of them is basically bigger. Now here's a full example. Assume we have three students and three ages. So I created here an array of three students. First one is 30 years old, it's Julian. Then we have Max, 28, and so on. Now we can call qsort on our students array and say it's three elements because that's the number of students we have. We have to tell it how big are the elements. Well, they are size of student T big, so that many bytes. And now we want to sort by age, so we put in our age comparator. And then we would get it sorted by age, basically. So the array after that on the zeroth element is whatever person that has the smallest age. Similarly, we can now use our name comparator, and now we have sorted it by alphanumerical sorting. And we can again take the first element, and we have our output.